Welcome to Insider Look here with CES, and I am joined today by a special guest, Deanna Kovar, Vice President of Production and Precision Agricultural Production Systems at John Deere. Deanna, thank you for your time, and woo, that is a title.
Yeah, thanks for having me. It is a lot to say.
Right off the bat, thank you for bringing this incredible virtual background. It might be the best virtual background that I've seen so far, so that looks amazing.
Brian, it's not virtual. This is the real deal. We've got
that
big tractor down there is our current production tractor. It's the one we showed at CES last year that we've made autonomous, and the one right behind it with the yellow wheel is over 100 years old. That's a Waterloo Boy, one of the first tractors that John Deere ever made over a century ago. So this is the real deal.
Can you tell us, you know, why coming to CES has been important to you?
We're super excited to come back to CES in 2023 for our fifth time. Mm. And we're excited to do it because it's an opportunity for us to advocate for agriculture and for the thousands and thousands of farmers who around the world get up every day thinking about how they can grow more with less to feed a growing population.
I know that one of the big themes that John Deere has really talked about and championed is this purpose-driven technology. And I know this ties into, you know, what you are all doing. So what is that and what does it really mean to you all?
We live up to the legend, the man, John Deere, every day here at John Deere, but we're also thinking about how we can forge the cutting edge and really bring technologies that other industries are using to the farm at scale and have a real impact on everyone that is on this planet.
So this is kind of a philosophy that's just really core to your DNA, right?
Yeah, one of our four core values is innovation. You know, John Deere the man 185 years ago was an innovator and helped break in a good way, break the Midwestern soil so that farmers could farm it and really become productive. And over the course of our 185 years of history, innovation has been at the heart of everything we do.
So I had just heard about John Deere's GPS network. Now, I hope I'm not saying, is it Starfire? Is that the name of the GPS network?
That's right. It's the Starfire network. You can see a yellow dome on the big tractor behind me. That's a Starfire position receiver. And we're one of five companies in the world that do satellite-based correction. So we take the GPS and GNSS signals from many different providers, and we through our own terrestrial-based correction signals, we correct that so that farmers everywhere in the world, over 100 countries in the world today, are using this technology. It is what helps machines drive themselves through the field, mostly with an operator still in the seat, but taking that tedious job of driving and the stress of it out of the farmer's hands so they can focus on the job they're doing in the field. But it's also the foundation for the autonomy strategy that we rolled out at CES last year.
What are maybe some of the challenges that farmers are facing today? And then how is the technology that you're really creating for them? How has that helped address some of those challenges?
Really at the heart of it, it's a challenge that humanity faces on this earth, right? We're going to move from about 7.8 billion people on the planet to nearly 10 billion people by the year 2050. And because many of those folks are having better lives, their diets are improving as well. So 25 to 30% increase in population means that agriculture has to grow 50% more food to feed that population. And that's a huge undertaking for agriculture as you think of the fact that, you know, available land to farm isn't actually growing. It's stable at this point. And so in order to do that, we've got to figure out how to grow more on the same land with less inputs as well, because sustainability is on the mind of every one of us, including farmers, for how we can do an even better job of driving sustainability.
CES also has this Human Security for All initiative, and obviously food security is part of that. So how does what John Deere is doing align with this whole Human Security for All initiative?
John Deere's mission is to help feed the world at the heart of it. And now that's everyone, that's everywhere. So it's about how can we leverage this technology in every part of the world going forward so that no matter the size and scale of your operation, John Deere has a technology tool that can help you do more. And then of course, it's founded in the environmental opportunity that we have. Farmers are the ultimate stewards of the land. At the end of the day, the land that farmers farm is what they have to hand down to their next generation. And so every day farmers get up looking for ways to improve their land and do more with less. And so this intersection of feeding the world and doing it in a highly sustainable way is perfectly lined up.
Okay, Deanna, before I let you go, I'm gonna throw you the hardest question of the day, okay?
I'm ready.
Where can attendees actually find you all on the CES floor? And, you know, maybe what can they expect to see at your booth this year?
Well, first, I would point anyone who's watching now to johndeere.com/CES, where you can see some of our prior years' attempts at sharing to the world what John Deere is and why agriculture is one of the most tech-advanced industries in the world. But this year in January 2023, come visit us in West Hall, where you'll be able to see our booth, where we'll highlight amazing technologies that are helping farmers farm better. You'll also see us start to bring in how we're leveraging that technology into the construction space. So you'll see one of our other industries. And of course, on day one of CES, you can also hear more about John Deere in our keynote address, where our CEO, John May, will be sharing with the world the vision we have of bringing technology to the farm as well. So lots of opportunities to see John Deere, but come talk to me in West Hall. I look forward to it.
Deanna, thank you for your time. Thank you for your knowledge and just incredible. I mean, I'm real excited to see you all at CES, and thanks again. And we will see you soon.
Awesome. Thanks a lot, Brian. Have a great day.
You too.